With a rich calendar of events dedicated to arts and culture, spring in Milan will be the perfect moment for art lovers. The Arte Moderna e Contemporanea auction stands out within these events, with an exquisite selection of works by renowned artists including Fontana, Scheggi, Bonalumi and Castellani. Leading the sale is the impressive selection of works by Lucio Fontana. These artworks demonstrate the endless creativity of Fontana, a key reference for many young post-war artists. These elegant compositions feature unusual yet captivating colors, new variations on Fontana's well-known slashes. Not everyone knows that the origin of famous cuts resides in a rush of holes wisely thrown on the canvas. The gesture is never urgent or emotional, but meditated and cleverly executed. In 1960, a black aniline canvas is penetrated by a delicate flowering shape of holes, which anticipates the Ritratto di Don Quixote ballet scenography held in 1967 at Teatro La Scala. In 1968, towards the end of Fontana's life, this variation of holes is perfectly arranged, surrounded by a colorful green frame. Dated 1956, this large gesso crossed by a delicate constellation of tiny holes shows a mysterious, smooth, rounded shape, which was ironically named Panettone by the artist. The blue canvas, dated 1961, is dominated by a strong single slash in the middle of the surface, treated with a thick and irregular pattern, which can be related to the Venice series conceived in the same year. An extraordinary group of ceramics dated from 1940 to early 60s shows the whole career of Fontana as sculptor. Combate Indio and Fondo Marino are glazed figures, both executed in the 40s. They embody a triumph of color and marvelous light reflections. We can easily see the abstract sculptures as the three-dimensional version of the Concetto Spaziale metaphor, the base of the specialism movement that started in 1946 with the Manifesto Blanco. The genius of Lucio Fontana is wonderfully revealed by this group of artworks. Each piece contributes to enrich the knowledge of his never-ending invention.